हेलो फ्रेंड, दिस इज दीपक जाधव, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर केएनपीएससी आर्ट्स कॉमर्स एंड विनायकराव पाटील साइंस कॉलेज कुर्डुवाड़ी सोलापुर। फ्रेंड्स, वी ऑब्जर्व वेरियस प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स अराउंड अस। हाउएवर, देयर आर सम लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर नॉट विजिबल टू अवर अनएडेड और नेकेड आइज। दीज टाइनी ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर कॉल्ड एज माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स और माइक्रोब्स। द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर प्रेजेंट इन एयर, वॉटर, सॉइल and also inside the bodies of plants and animals. Friends, from my childhood, I was having some questions that why the food gets spoiled, why we get cottony growth on the surface of the bread, why humans get diseased, why the water gets polluted, how do we get the curd, and how the dead animals get decomposed.
So friends, today we are going to find all the answers to these questions. And today's topic of our video is harmful and beneficial activities of microorganisms. So friends, let us start with the harmful activities of microorganisms. Friends, the pathogen cause great losses to plants and animal population by causing several diseases. Some important bacterial diseases of plants and animals, including human being, is given in these tables. You can go through it by pausing the video. Friends, next harmful activity of microorganisms is reduction of soil fertility. Some facultative anaerobic bacteria are available mostly in oxygen deficient soil, which reverse the nitrifying process, thereby causing the loss of part of its combined nitrogen. They break down the nitrates in a stepwise manner, either to ammonia through assimilatory nitrate reduction or to nitrogen through the dissimilatory nitrate reduction. The free nitrogen goes to the atmosphere, resulting in the reduction of soil fertility by losing valuable nitrogen source. The bacteria those cause denitrification are called as denitrifying bacteria. For example, Bacillus cereus, Paracoccus denitrificans, and Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Friends, next harmful activity of microorganism is spoilage of food. In favorable temperature and humidity, bacteria can grow luxuriantly in many food materials. They change the flavor, appearance, and smell of the food. Different species of Streptococcus, Micrococcus, and Lactobacillus cause spoilage of milk and different milk products. The exotoxin produced by Clostridium botulinum causes botulism. Botulism disease, showing the symptoms like swelling of tongue, double vision, and respiratory disturbance. Friends, next harmful activity of microorganism is pollution of water. Some microbes pollute water and make it unsuitable for drinking. The diseases like cholera, typhoid, dysentery are commonly transmitted by drinking water. Next harmful activity is abortion. Some species of Salmonella and Listeria cause abortion of sheep, horse, goat, humans, and other animals. Next harmful activity of microorganism is biological warfare. The microbes causing diseases like anthrax, blackleg, tuberculosis, the viruses like corona and H1N1 may be used as secret war agents. Friends, now we will see the beneficial activities of microorganisms. The first beneficial activity of microorganisms is it increases the soil fertility. Plants do not have the efficiency of direct utilization of huge amount of atmospheric nitrogen. However, some free-living and symbiotic bacteria are able to fix free nitrogen into nitrogenous compounds. These bacteria are of following categories. The first category is nitrifying bacteria. The nitrifying bacteria oxidizes ammonia to nitrate in two steps. The first step involves the oxidation of ammonia into nitrous acid by bacteria like Nitrosomonas, and second step involves the oxidation of nitrous acid into nitric acid by Nitrobacter. Second category of bacteria is ammonifying bacteria. Some saprophytic bacteria hydrolyze the protein of dead animals and plants into amino acids. Some ammonifying bacteria then converts the amino acids into ammonia,
which further combines with water and carbon dioxide to form ammonium carbonate. The ammonium carbonate is used by many plants as a nitrogen source. Third category of bacteria is nitrogen fixing bacteria. These bacteria can fix the atmospheric nitrogen. These bacteria are of two types, that is the symbiotic nitrogen fixers and non-symbiotic nitrogen fixers. The symbiotic nitrogen fixers are rhizobium, those are found in root nodules of leguminous plants, and non-symbiotic nitrogen fixers or free living nitrogen fixers are Azotobacter and Clostridium. Now we are going to discuss the industrial importance of microorganisms. Friends, from ancient times, men have used microorganisms in the preparation of their food, drinks, etc. Some of the industrial uses of microorganisms are used in dairy industry, the lactic acid bacteria used in the preparation of butter, cheese, curd, etc. The curd is prepared from milk by bacteria in two steps. They convert the lactose sugar into glucose and the glucose into the lactic acid, which stores the milk and coagulates the milk protein, that is casein, forming the curd. Some bacteria used in the dairy industry are Lactobacillus plantarum, Lactobacillus acidophilus and Lactobacillus bulgaricus. Next industry is vinegar industry. Clostridium acidobutylicum and Acetobacter acidi. These bacteria are used in the conversion of alcohol to acetic acid, that is the vinegar. This was done in wooden vats and takes several weeks to complete the process. Next industry is butanol and acetone production industry. Butanol and acetone are produced by action of species of Clostridium on molasses. They are used as solvents in different industries. Next industry is fiber netting industry. Butyric acid bacteria such as Clostridium tetani, Clostridium botulinum, etc. are used in the netting of jute, hemp and flax fibers. Thereby, the bast fibers become loose and can be extracted easily. Next is curing of tea and tobacco. Curing of tea and tobacco is done by some bacteria which give particular taste, flavor and smell to the tea and tobacco. Now, we will discuss the biological control of insects. Many bacteria like Bacillus thuringiensis secrete proteins which are highly toxic to caterpillars and insects belonging to Lepidoptera. They are, however, non-toxic to other animals and plants. Thereby, the bacteria are used as ideal agent for biocontrol of insects. Next use of microorganism is degradation of petroleum. Many bacteria like Pseudomonas, Micrococcus, Candida and Acromobacter are able to degrade petroleum hydrocarbon in water from different vehicles, thereby they control the pollution. Next use is decomposition of dead animals. Some bacteria are able to decompose the dead organic matter into inorganic form, which mix with soil and increase the soil fertility. These inorganic substances are then absorbed by the plants as nutrients. Next use is bacteria in medicine. Bacteria are the sources of different antibiotics, serum and vaccines. Antibiotics are the chemical substances secreted by microorganisms which inhibit the growth and development of other microorganisms. Antibiotics like paciprocin, polymyxin B, terramycin, streptomycin, etc. are bacterial origin. The serum and vaccines are also we can obtain from the bacteria or microorganisms. Next, benefit of microorganism is production of vitamins. Some bacteria produce vitamins of commercial importance. Pseudomonas dinitrificans produces cobalamin vitamin B12 and Clostridium butylicum produces riboflavin, that is vitamin B2. Next use is in sewage work. Putrefying bacteria are used to remove the solid and semi-solid constituents of sewage under anaerobic condition. After treatment, the constituents get decayed and liquefied. Those are filtered and the liquid is drained out in the river. Next and the last benefit of microorganism is preservation of green fodder. Some bacteria are used in the preservation of green powder in pills. Thank you so much. Friends, if you have liked the information given in this video, press the like button, share it, and if you have not subscribed the channel, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much.